Praise the Lord, the Spirit of the Lord is in this house. As we stand, we are going to read the Bible. We are going to open in Exodus 2, 23 and 24. And it came to pass in process of time that the king of Egypt died, and the children of Israel sang it by reason of the bondage, and they cried, and their cry came up to God by reason of the bondage. And God heard their groaning, and God remembered his covenant with Abraham, with Isaac, and with Jacob. We also going to read Exodus 6, 5, and 7. And I have also heard the groaning of the children of Israel, whom the Egyptians keep in bondage, and I have remembered my covenant. Wherefore say unto the children of Israel, I am the Lord, I am will bring you out from under the burden of the Egyptian. I will lead you out of their bondage, and I will redeem you in a stretched out arm and with a great judgment. I will take you to me for a people, and I will be your God. And ye shall know that I am the Lord your God, which brings you out of the from under the burden of the Egyptian. And we are also going to read Exodus 13, 17 to 18. It came to pass when Pharaoh had let the people to go, that God led them not through the way of the land of the Philistines, although that was near. For God said, lest peradventure the people repent when they see war, they return to Egypt. I want to read that verse even in NIV. When Pharaoh let the people go, God did not lead them into the road through the Palestine country. Through was shorter. For God said, if they face war, they might change their mind and return to Egypt. So God led the people around the desert road toward the Red Sea. The Israelites went up of Egypt, ready for battle. Praise the Lord. Let's go before the Lord. Oh Lord Jesus, we give you the glory, give you the honor, oh Lord. We ask you to be here with us, O Lord, and minister to us, O Lord Jesus. We want to hear from you, O Lord Jesus, tonight, O Lord. You have laid the table for us, O Lord Jesus. We give you all the glory, Father, O Lord. Open our hearts and our ears, O Lord, so we can hear from you, O Lord Jesus. We give you all the praise, Father. I say thank you for your everything. I think by reading all those verses I've read, you have understood my message tonight is about the Egypt, from Egypt to Canaan. That is my message for me tonight. Before I go, what I have, I want to say something. You can sit down. This message came to me when I was in a big trouble. All you know what I have gone through in the last 2-3 months with my wife and my baby. So this message came to me. One day I was waiting to see my child in the incubator. You know, sometimes you are sitting there for 2 or 3 hours until they open the door so we can see our child for 15 minutes. Imagine you're waiting for 2 or 3 hours just to see a child for 15 minutes. So as we were waiting there, sometimes I didn't have anything to do. So in those days, because I went there, in the end they told me that my child stayed in the incubator for 51 days. I could not believe that I was there every day for 51 days. But every day I was going. But every day the Lord was giving something. So this one day he gave me the Exodus. I could not understand why he gave me the Exodus. You know, sometimes the Lord can give you the message, but because you are not there, you cannot know the message. So this is a message, it was speaking to me. That's why I wanted this message to even me to talk about it today, because this message is about what I have gone through. Because I was in Egypt with my wife and my child in the hospital. We were in Egypt, we were in the bondage of the sickness, and then one day the Lord came and took us and to make us to the green pastures to Canaan. He would take my wife and my child in home. That for me was Canaan. For everyone, the Canaan can be something different. For me, I was in Egypt and he brought me to Canaan. But before he give me this verse, that God did not lead them on the road near the Philistine country through, though it was shorter, but he made them to go through the desert. That message was speaking to me. You know, the Lord could have done the miracle and give my wife to come out of the hospital sooner, or do a miracle with my child who will not stay for so long in the hospital. But he wanted to teach me something. He wanted out of that for me to understand something. And I hope I understand, because the Lord brought me all that way, but every day was giving me something. In those process of waiting, I read a lot of books. I read Samuel. That's even from the Samuel I got the name of my baby Hannah, because she was the mother of the Samuel. You see, the Lord was giving me some things to do, some things to read, because he had a purpose for me. You know, sometimes the bondage, the Egypt, is we take ourselves without even knowing, sometimes they're knowing. The children of Israel, they went themselves to Egypt. But when they went, it was sweet, it was very good. But after a while, their freedom became a bondage. The same in our life. Sometimes we go somewhere because it's beautiful, because it's nice. But after a while, when we are there, is when we realize that we have put ourselves in the bondage. You know, sometimes we see a very good job far away. We can see maybe an opportunity, we go far away. Maybe one day somebody call you, I'll give you 1500, you come and work with me in an island. But what you're forgetting, when you go to the island, you are going far away from the Lord. It's not an opportunity. It's something the devil has given to you to draw you out of the eye of the Lord. The way he did with the children of Israel, he brought them to Egypt. And when they went to Egypt, what happened? They started worship the gods of Egypt. They went away from God. That's what happened to us. So when something good comes to you, an opportunity comes, pray about it. If it is opportunity that comes, it can draw you away from the church. Let me tell you, it's better you don't go, because maybe it's sweeter today, but tomorrow you'll be crying. Tomorrow you'll see where you have put yourself to. The way even the children of Egypt, they were. You know, sometimes we are even in a spiritual bondage without even knowing. Sometimes we put, not even for material things, even our spirit, sometimes we struggle with some things. We put ourselves in some bondage today that we cannot come out. But he said, the Lord, if you cry to him, he'll remove you from the bondage. That is a mighty God we serve. He always there. In another verse in the Bible, say that the Lord looked from her and he saw, he recognized the children of Israel. He recognized them because the Lord knows his children. As a father knows his children, even when you are a parent, if you see a child, even if with 50,000 people recognize your child, the same in our Lord, he can recognize us even wherever we are. But let not take us, let ourselves not take us ourselves to bondage, because that's what we do most of the time. Most of the things we go through is we have taken ourselves to. We serve a mighty God. We serve a King of Kings that he can provide everything and anything. You know, the children of Israel, they went to Egypt because they didn't have food. But if they could have prayed, the Lord could have provided to them. If they could have stayed, the Lord could provide to them. The same to us. I have seen a lot of people from this church. They're going out. Maybe they try to go find a greener pasture. But what happened? It becomes like a bondage where they are. It becomes something that they cry because they went away from the Lord and they forgot about the Lord. You know, when you are not near your church, you are not near the Lord, slowly, slowly, the enemy is eating you. He's eating you. Until one day, you don't have power to fight. And the enemy now, he claims victory. But when you're in the church, even when you go out, you come back, you refill yourself. Every time you refill yourself, you are ready to walk. So let's go, let's stay near the church. Let's stay near God so he can refill us wherever we have a problem. You know, in today's world, I was seeing in my working place, I can see a lot of young people, because it's like a youth, you host them. You see young people, they are addicted in so many things. They are drugs, alcohol, money, TV. They are addicted in everything. Today the world offers a lot of things they can be addicted. Now in the American election, You see people, even they are fighting because of one leader or the other, but they forget there's only one leader, and that is Jesus. That is only the leader they're supposed to follow. If you want to be addicted in something, be addicted in Jesus Christ, and you will not fail. If you are addicted in Jesus Christ, you will never fail. Praise the Lord. You know, when I was in that hospital, there are some things I was supposed to, some steps to do to come out of the bondage. But me, I could not understand that moment. There are some things you must do when you go and stuck somewhere. There are some steps you must do. First, you must believe on God. You know, when you got sick, you try to find the best doctor. You try to find someone you know in the hospital. That is human things. The only things we need to do is believe in God. Come to the your knee. Don't go search for the doctor, but come to your knee here. Believe God can do it. The Israelites, they show obedience to God by obeying the command of Passover. Because whoever obeyed the command of the Passover lived. But whoever did not obey, he perished. That's the way we are. Let's obey the commands of the Lord. Let's obey what the Lord is saying. Because sometimes we think it's hard, but it's not hard. If you obey the Lord, it will make you through. The second thing the Lord will do to make you out of the bondage is break any oppression power. You know, when you're going through something, there's a powers who come to hold you back. You know, when in the hospital, the doctors were coming, bringing bad news. That is the power of the darkness. They were bringing the bad news. That's what the Lord can destroy. When the Lord says go, all power get paralyzed. How he paralyzed the power of Israelites? When he killed the firstborn. When he killed the firstborn, the Pharaoh, he didn't have any power to fight the Lord. So he let the children of Israel go. The same in our situation. When you want to go somewhere, you want to leave the bondage where you are, the Lord will paralyze the power that holding you. It will put paralyzed. You'll see, you'll be walking and you'll see, before I could not walk, why now I walk? Because the Lord has paralyzed every power. The third thing is deliverance. As they went out of the Egypt, they must abandon their old ways. That's the problem we have today. We are saved, but our mind still is there for the outside. Sometimes you can hear the music of the world you are listening to before, and you start doing the beats. Because our mind has never left the world. We must leave the world. We must leave the world and come to the kingdom of God. The way the Egyptian, the Lord said, leave everything, I'll provide to you. It's the same thing we must do. There are some things we have in our house that it was from our past. We must let them go. It may be clothes. It may be jewelry. We must put them aside if you want to go with the Lord. If you want the Lord to remove you from the bondage, you must let them before. You must let them go. You know, sometimes in the world you can give. Maybe you have a golden cross and you say it's very expensive. You don't want to. Throw it or give it away, but maybe that is your bondage. That's what the devil holding you with. But today you must take a decision and let it go. You must say, no, I will let it go. I will follow Christ. Our Christ is not in the cross, not in the gold, but it's in heaven. So it's a living God. It's not in the one in the cross we see people carry. No, let's leave our things of the past there and start our journey to Canaan. Because that is the journey our Lord wants to take us. The fourth thing that the Lord will do is complete deliverance. There's deliverance and there's complete deliverance. You know, when the children of Israel were living in Egypt, Pharaoh let them go. Then Pharaoh changed their mind, and he wanted the children of Israel again. So he went against them. But there, the Lord said, I will show him I am. Well, you can see that in Exodus 14 and 18. The Egyptians shall know that I am the Lord. You see, he said they will know who the Lord is. Even in your situation, they will know who the Lord is. He will do a total deliverance to your life. He will soon do something that everybody will see that the Lord is I am. I am. In the Jesus Christ, they will see something they have not seen. we see how Jesus magnified himself in the children of Israel. When they were rich in the sea, it was dead for the children of Israel. But what the Lord did, even today the sons cannot do. He opened the sea. The sons, they tried. Everybody, every human being has tried to see if that thing will happen. It's happened. The Lord opened the sea. The children of Israel passed. But when the Pharaoh and his soldiers tried to pass, the sea came back. That is the power of the Almighty. That's the power of the God we serve. That he, when he wants to do to truly and complete deliverance, he will do something big. He will do something that everybody will say, that is the Lord. That is the Lord you serve. Praise the Lord. And the fifth and the last thing, the deliverance is the wilderness. You know, when you take them to the wilderness, he had so many things he wanted to do to them. He wanted to train them. He wanted the children of Israel to know who is their God. Because when they are in the bondage, they had forgotten who is their God. The same with us. When we sometimes we go in a good job, we forget who Jesus is. We forget what he has done to our lives. So when he brings us out of the bondage, he must take us to school again. He must take us and tell you, I am the Lord. I am the Lord who has made you to who you are today. You know, the Lord could have taken the easy way. The same way with my child, he could have taken the easy way. But he taken it the hard way because he wanted to teach me, to take me back, that to know that I must trust in him with all my heart. I must put everything in him. That's what he wanted to teach me. Sometimes it's very hard. You see, you cry to the Lord. I remember I was crying day and night, why Lord me? Why Lord me? But I could not see myself that I have forgotten who the Lord is in my life. That's what he wanted to show me. And the Lord, if you yourself cannot understand, the Lord will show you the hard way. First, he wanted to change their mind. He wanted everything they knew about Egypt to forget. You know, in 40 years, if you stay in this country for 40 years, you will forget even your village. You will forget everything that you knew in your village. If you stay, the same thing what the Lord wanted to do. When they were in the wilderness, they forget about Egypt. They forget what they are doing. They forget what they are eating. And they started eating from the Lord. They knew their provider is the Lord. They knew everything they need is from the Lord. It's not from the Egyptian. It's not from anyone else. The other thing the Lord wanted to know, to show them, which is most important, he wanted to give them the law. He wanted to give them the law that they must obey. He wanted to show them, he wanted to give them how they will live from now on. How God will be their head. That's the other thing the Lord wanted to show them. But the law the Lord gives them is not only for the material thing. The law he gives them even for their spirit. As they were living by the laws, their spirit grew. They started believing in Christ. They started seeing Christ in every way. As they reached Canaan, all their mind was in Christ. You remember the story of the ten people they were sent to search for, to see the Canaan. They ate, brought by the bad news. Because their mind was still in Egypt. Their mind was still in Egypt. They could not see what the Lord is giving to them. You know, sometimes the Lord can take you somewhere, you see, the Lord, how can I overcome this? But you don't see what the Lord sees. He has already given you. He said, this land is full of milk and honey. But you must have the eyes of the Lord to see that. If you have the world eyes, you will not see that. You all see all the troubles. But you remember when Joshua and Caleb, what they see? They see what Jesus was seeing. Milk and honey. They could not see the giant. They could not see anything. He was seeing only milk and honey. That's why Joshua and Caleb were blessed. Because they were seeing with the eyes of the Lord. The same thing we must see in ourselves. When trouble comes, don't look with your eyes. Pray and say, Lord, where I'm going, and the Lord will direct you. He will take you. Even if that road is full of snake, nothing will bite you. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
You know, I read another verse in the Bible that touched me. It is Romans 6 and 16. Know ye not that whom you yet yourself servant to obey, he servant ye are whom you obey, whether of sin unto death, or obey unto righteousness. In NIV say, don't you know that when you offer yourself to someone as obedience, slave, you are a slave of what you obey, whether you are a slave of sin which lead to death, or obedience which lead to righteousness. Who do you obey today? Who do you obey? You know, some people obey money. Money leads to death. Who do you obey today? You obey the Lord or you obey the sin of the world? That is the question of today. You know, sometimes people, they say, you see people, they go in like, that their eyes are closed, they go like this. Because that's what they obey. That's what they see. But we see Jesus. We see Jesus. And that's why we have righteousness. That's why we have life. That's why even when the crisis comes, we're still smiling. You know, when you are a child of God, you don't see crisis. You see Jesus. Praise the Lord. Our Jesus is mighty. He has a place of milk and honey for you. But you are struggling with the small things. Let leave Egypt. Let we leave Egypt. The road is long. But in the end of the road, there's milk and honey. Praise the Lord. Our Lord is there for us. Don't be afraid. Don't be afraid. You know, when I was with the child in the hospital, he reached a time that I was not afraid what the doctor would say. The doctor was coming and tell us bad news, but I would say, Jesus is in your heart. There's nothing I can do. You know, in the incubator, when the children are in the incubator, if you go to the incubator room, you see the Greeks, they bring the cross, the other they bring the icon of Panagia, the other they bring something that this came from a monastery, they bring an olive tree, it's anointed. But me, what I had, I was just laying my hand and saying, the blood of Jesus. That's only what I was giving to my child. That's the only thing I was giving to myself, the blood of Jesus. Because by the blood of Jesus, everything is covered. Everything is covered. So let's cover ourselves with the blood of Jesus. Let's hold on Jesus. Let's hold to Jesus. Let's hold in Jesus. And let all of us go to Canaan. Because the Lord is there. It's not for us to proclaim it. You know, Egypt can be so many things to any person. To you, maybe a sin. To other person, maybe a prison, you know, a work that he wants to get out of. It can be anything. So let's come out. If you are working somewhere and you don't feel comfortable because of what you are doing, is the time to come out. It's the time to say, the Lord, I'm here. Take me where I'm supposed to be. Praise the Lord. You know, the job I was working before, I was working even Sunday, and I was praying, Lord, take me out of here. The money was good, let me tell you. I was being paid very good in that job. But I was feeling bad when Sunday came and I was not going to the church. And I said, Lord, take me out of this job. And the job he take me, the salary was less than half that I was taking. But I was happy. Do you know why? Because I was coming to the house of the Lord. Praise the Lord. Let's stick in the house of the Lord. Let's stick with Jesus. Because only in Jesus we have freedom. Only in Jesus we are free. We have milk and honey. Praise the Lord. That is my message for tonight. That's the message that the Lord gave me when I was in the hospital all those days with my child. He wanted to teach me that I come to him. And I thank the Lord that he made me go through all of that just to teach me. That shows that the love he has for me. You know, sometimes you can go through something and see maybe the Lord has forsaken you. Or the Lord is doing something bad. But the Bible says the Lord will not leave you or forsaken you. Praise the Lord. The Lord, everything he's doing is for your own good. Praise the Lord. So even what you are going through today, is your road to Canaan. So when you're going hard time, praise the Lord. We are singing, praise the Lord, praise the Lord in the good or the bad time. Yes. Let's praise him in every moment. Because we know in the end we are going to Canaan. Praise the Lord. Thank you very much. That was my testimony. It was not exactly my teaching. It was a testimony from my heart. What the Lord did in my life and in my family. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord. Another hand clap. Glory to God. I believe the Lord just reminded us, because in life sometimes we want to dwell in a comfort zone. Praise the Lord. Bondage, being stuck, but remember, it's a covenant-keeping God.
Amen.
What He spoke to Abraham, entirely again spoke to this generation. Although they err, they fall down, but the Lord lift them up.
Amen.
He say, I will sure remind them of my covenant with Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, because He has called them my people. Some will call them stiff-necked fools, but God calls us His people. A righteous man may fall how many times? 7 times. But the Lord surely lift him up. Praise the Lord. It's time to understand that the Lord has something great for us. It's time to abandon what is just as an obstacle before us. Things being colorful over our eyes, this sometimes they cause us to stumble. These are sometimes that are bringing us back, dragging us not to worship fully the Lord. Sometimes they come in our thoughts, thinking of whom we are, forgetting of whom is holding us, forgetting of an author and the finisher of our faith, that is Jesus. But it's time just to let our mind open so that He can fill us again. It's time to come before Him and ask Him again, Lord, cleanse us. Show us the way. Lead us, we will follow. Praise the Lord. It's time to come out of bondage and understand that He's a covenant-keeping God.
Amen.
If you trust in Him fully, He will surely bring you out. Praise the Lord. He remembers His people. In spite of the world today, we are passing many difficulties. The Lord is informed. The Lord is involved. And the Lord is always there. He will surely bring us out. Praise the Lord. Let's give a hand clap for brothers. Let's come together to close this service. It has reminded me that things do happen, but the Lord is still on the throne.
Amen.
Everything that is coming to our life roughly, we believe that the Lord is still on the throne. The book of John says, if you remain in me and my words remain in you, ask whatever you will and it shall be done unto you. Praise the Lord. We're just going to pray and thank Him for His word today. Thanking Him just to erase or delete an Egyptian mind from our mind. That our mind is going to be free, that He may fill us again. As we leave out this place, we are fully filled Christians and children of God. Hallelujah. Jesus, we bless You this evening, Lord. We thank You for speaking unto us, Lord. Reminding us, oh Lord, that whatever will come unto pass, You are still the covenant-keeping God. Lord, we suffer in the world, but we are victorious before You, Lord. We die every day outward, but inward, Jesus, You are renewing us, Lord. We thank You today, Jesus, for speaking unto us. Clear our mind, O Lord. Let the light shine again into our hearts, Lord. This little light that is in us, Lord, we are going to let it shine outside, Lord. We are not going back to wilderness, O Jesus, but we are going, O Lord, to this land, Canaan, You have prepared for us, O Lord. We thank You, Lord, for speaking unto us. Even those who are not here, King of Glory, they will hear Your word, that the Spirit is still speaking. Hallelujah. We thank You as we leave this place, cover us with Your blood. We are going home with the instrument made by the human wisdom, but to soak ourselves in the blood of Jesus. Blessed be Your holy name. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. God bless you.